Welcome back to the Rhino JFR commands tutorial. Today, I will continue to explain the usage scenarios of the JFR command through multiple examples. Let's begin today's lesson. Now, I'm going to use this example to explain how to use the ring size and smash and flow along surface commands. First, create these patterns on the plane. These are created by me using rail sweep 2. Note that the number of control points on the two rail curves must be the same. Then use sweep 2 under rail to generate the surface. And just make a few more fine adjustments to the details. All of the patterns here are created using this method. Then use ring size and smash. Input the ring size. For example, a diameter of 17.6 millimeters. Then input the width of the unfolded surface. This width must be greater than the width of the ring. These two generated surfaces will be used for the flow operation. Select both the pattern and the flat surface. Move them downward for better visibility. Click Flow Along Surface. As prompted in the command bar, select the object to flow. Keep the copy option enabled. It is recommended to turn off Accurate so that the surface after flowing will not add control points. Click the base surface, then click the target surface. And just like that, the patterned ring is finished. If you need to adjust the pattern, simply edit it on the plane. It's very simple. If you want a curved surface ring, just modify the shape of the target surface. Click Rebuild Surface UV. Rebuild the control points in the V direction. Create a reference circle in the front view. Show the control points and then modify the shape of the target surface. Then use JFR's flow along surface to flow the pattern. This method makes it much easier to control the ring's overall shape. If you want to modify the ring sides, you can also add it on the flat surface. Scale inward. And the float object will follow the change. Scale it more. This gives the ring a more three-dimensional feel. That's how flow along surface works. Master this method, and you'll be able to design this kind of ring easily in the future. Now let's learn about the flow along curve command. Take this Mobius ring as an example. Draw a straight line using the vertical mirror curve. Then rebuild curve. 10 control points will be enough. Use polygon mirror curve to draw a square. Next, use single rail to generate a surface. Generate. Then select all the control points of the surface. Right-click the icon and use the twist command. Twist this square pipe. From the current view, make the control points overlap. Now create a circular curve. Then use flow along curve. It can flow planar objects onto the target curve. Right-click. Select the object to flow. This time, enable both copy and accurate options in the command bar. This ensures the resulting shape is smooth and round. Select the base curve, then select the target curve. And the Mobius ring is complete. If you want to modify its thickness, just modify both the base shape and base curve together. We can even make a gradient pattern on the flat surface. Select control points and scale them. The shape will update accordingly. That's the common use of the flow along curve command. Next, I'll use this case to explain the JFR squish command and easily create patterns on the ring shank. Now I'm going to quickly add these patterns to the ring shank. These patterns were also generated using the rail tool. Since there are few control points, it can be edited at any time. Now we need to trim the target surface. Draw a straight line. It is recommended to expand the trimming range outward a bit. Then divide out the other parts as well. This object was created with the extend command and then shaped into a trapezoid. The trim area also needs to be extended a bit. It's the same here. Select the control points and rotate downward. Here, extend to the left. Finally, trim out the surface. Once the surface is ready, we can add the pattern. Select the surface, then click Squish. Move this plane to the position of the pattern. Delete half of it. Right-click the icon. Select objects to unfold back, then press space. Click the unfolded plane, then click the unexpanded surface. The patterns on the flat surface will automatically flow onto it, and the patterns that have flowed onto it can be kept as much as possible without getting deformed. To edit it, just switch to multi-view mode. This makes it convenient for us to preview in real time. Some of the patterns here are not placed properly and need to be edited. When I make edits on the flat surface, it will change in real time here. Since all these patterns were made with the rail tool, we can turn on control points and continue editing. Very convenient. Finally, just mirror the remaining patterns to complete it. This is one of the common usage scenarios for squish command. Lastly, let's learn another RE algorithm for unfolding. I'll use both squish and RE to generate the same pattern and compare the differences. First, use squish. Open auto pattern. Use it to generate the pattern. Edit the generated values appropriately. generated. Right-click the icon. Flow the pattern onto this surface. The patterns flowing with Squish look relatively uniform when viewed from the front. Now draw a profile. I am going to use Rail Sweep 1 to generate the surface. Select all the curves. Open the Rail tool and select Sweep 1. Select the profile. Fit it to the surface. With Squish, designing this type of style becomes easier. By adjusting the profile, we can modify the thickness of the pattern. That's the result using Squish. Now let's try RE command and compare the unfolding methods. The RE command will automatically convert the curved surface into a mesh and then unfold it. Then use the same method to create the pattern. Select all the curves. Right-click the icon. Flow the curves onto the mesh. Then use Rail to generate the surface. Hide the fitting surface to make it convenient for observation. For the objects that flow up using the RE, there will be a slight change in the spacing of their surfaces. The patterns flowing with Squish will have a slight stretch on the side. However, the objects flowing with RE appear more uniform overall. Each algorithm has its own advantages. You can choose the suitable one based on your needs. Finally, let's explain the options in Auto Pattern. The unfolding algorithm here is actually the several types that we have just explained. If we directly use Auto Pattern, we can skip the unfolding process and then directly generate the pattern. However, these unfolding commands are extremely versatile and capable of flowing any type of object. Therefore, in daily work, you can simply choose them flexibly according to the actual situation. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching this far. If this video was helpful to you, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to us. See you next time.